Hi everyone and welcome to the HWBOT World Tour 2016. We are here in Poitiers at the Gamers Assembly in France. And today is the last day of this event. We are doing the HWBOT World Series Final. I'm Truthman from Overclocking TV. And I've been joined for the complete day of commentary on all these finals by our dear friend Lee Goft. How are you, my friend?
Yeah, very happy to be here, finally. Yeah. This time it's not that far away. Like, you guys were like in South Africa, that would have been like brilliant to be there as well. But France was already like an 8-hour drive for us. So yeah, pretty happy to be here. Pretty excited how it will work out. MOA is back, isn't it?
MOA is back. This is the Master Overclocking Arena. So the Extreme guys for the HWBOT World Series here in Poitiers for the European stop will actually do compete in the Master Overclocking Arena Europe 2016. That's quite interesting because last year the MOA was only online after seven years being held as with live qualifiers and live final. Everyone was a bit like, oh, sad that it was not happening again. And this is it. It's happening again. This is the time that we can do the MOA live again. This is super great. So thank you, Lego, for being with us. If you guys have any questions on the live chat, don't hesitate to ask us because we will be monitoring the live chat. It's actually right in front of us. So Lego will be reading all your mean comments if you have any of them. And of course, we will be here all day. We will be commenting on both the Extreme Final and the Amateur Final. And we will have a quick look after that at the schedule itself. So Lego, what are you doing in life? Like, who are you? Why are you our expert here today?
I don't know. Oh. Maybe because I have a lot of free time. I did like extreme overclocking like a long while already. I was introduced to it by Mr. Massman himself, so had our current overclocking lord at HWBOT. And indeed, I've been not really that competitive guy, but I've been like through all the platforms, let's say from Intel Socket 775, AMD 939, and just each year like adapting to the new technology, which is quite cool. Huh? It's like every time we get like new toys to play with and you have to learn new things and like especially the last few years have been like really interesting with all the high memory speeds and really difficulty to bench all the CPUs. We really have to adapt each time to the new platform. So I hope I can reply to all the technical questions. I hope they're not too technical, but at least give some good info and also what's happening out on the outside, what's happening in the action. So yeah, looking
Although
forward
one
to
thing, you do a lot of live demo as well. Last weekend you were commenting with us part of the World Tour and the World Series in South Africa where we are in in Cape Town for the Rage, and you do as well do the demo like this, so you can explain quite easily to other people what you can do for that. So that's actually the main reason why you are with us, because you know how to talk to people.
Okay, cool.
Oh, you didn't knew that?
No.
Okay, so let's go to the competition now. So we will be starting the first semi-final here, and the guys did qualify yesterday. How was that for the qualifier, Ligoft?
Yeah, they had like a 3-hour total run. So they had to compete in three benchmarks. So GPU Pi, it was 3D Mark 11 and the XTU one.
That was XTU at 5 GHz. SuperPi 32M and 3D Mark 11 physics.
Yeah, that was especially the 5 GHz limit. Huh? So everybody could use, let's say that first, their own platform. They could bring their own hardware. So it was not limited to the hardware that they're using right now. So everybody had like a lot of time to prepare. Everybody knew their own CPU and everybody could, let's say, tweak the OS. The only thing they got for the qualifier was the memory.
And the memory was not known by anyone before.
Yeah.
That was a completely new memory kit. No one knew about that kit before. No one had information about the chips that were used as well on this memory kit. So that was a complete surprise for everyone. And we had the top eight that did show up this morning for the semi-final.
Indeed, they were like here pretty early this morning and they were like testing all the features of the boards and trying to dial in the memory, because indeed they got everything yesterday evening. So there some guys told me they slept like 1 hour, 2 hours, even max. So yeah, that's what overclocking is all about. Sometimes you have to be real die hard to get like into these competitions.
Speaking of lack of sleep, there's actually WebSmile on the chat that says, you guys look as if you had a good party or not enough sleep. Definitely not enough sleep.
Enough
you didn't have the time to party at all for the whole weekend, because we are here at the HWBOT World throughout the Gamers Assembly and it's been packed with stuff. Like we had over 20 overclockers, extreme overclockers overclocking at the gathering, and they did qualify yesterday. yeah. top 8. And they did. We just finished the quarterfinal. The quarterfinal was like one versus one as well to define who will go in the next stage. If you look at the quarterfinal, did happen. That was the same thing. One match, 30 minutes, one benchmark. They all benched the WPRM 32M.
No, so there was like a difference. They also did the veto thing, like where I used to now at the HWBOT World Tour. So Dan Kopp went up to Airu and they did like GPU Pi 100M. We had Bruno versus Orion 24, so one of the new overclockers that was introduced to, let's say, extreme overclocking last year. He did the amateur tour part and he went straight to the extreme overclocker. So pretty cool to see that guy here. Then we had Extreme Addict versus Azolio, so one of the more renowned members, and that we all know that Extreme Addict is all over the place. And finally, you had Wizardy, so let's say the number one in France, versus Bullshooter, one of the guys from the Etusit League of Germany. And they went all the Cinebench R11.5, and Extreme Addict and Azolio went for the W Prime 32M. We already seen a lot of difference like in CPU speeds already. I think Dan Kopp, the current number one in HWBOT ranking, he has like the weakest CPU. He can just barely do 6060 megahertz.
But still, he passed the quarterfinal already, so yeah. it's only the semifinal. We just got the call that there's only 4 minutes before the first match. So let's go about the concept of this final. So it's one versus one. So they did qualify yesterday. They fight one versus one for the qualifier. They will fight one versus one in the semifinal as well and in the final. We will also have a bronze final for the two the two loser bracket. The loser bracket, basically, for the semifinal.
Loser final, yeah.
I don't like calling that loser bracket because you're not a loser. You already end up in the final.
Yeah, I know.
It's just to know who will be third and who will be fourth. That's the only...
Everybody wants to win, finally.
Yeah.
So that's...
Definitely. So it's one versus one. All the guys have 30 minutes to bench for the extreme, for the MOA. They will have to choose... from six benchmark, so they don't really choose directly the benchmark. It's a draw, and they have 15 seconds to veto or to take this benchmark. Each overclocker have one veto. So let's say I take the first benchmark, I don't like it, I can veto straight away.
Yep.
But if the second benchmark is not good either, and the other guys don't veto, you're stuck with it. No choice.
Indeed. I think Daniel really wants to maybe rule out the XTU because he can't get the CPU as high. Maybe he can tweak the memory. That's the thing where you can maybe can gain some extra points. But if, I don't know what frequency Orion 24 could run, but I think it was close to 6,200 as well. So we'll see. We just have to see what will happen. Of course, these guys already benched like for 30 minutes. They didn't have that much time to, let's say, dry up the system because normally the schedule was a little bit different.
Yep.
But we had some technical issues to get everything started. So, yeah, they're already like setting up and...
They're almost ready.
Ready.
They
should be ready. It starts in 2 minutes.
In 2 minutes. So they will have to choose a bit. We will switch to Peter later on today, and we'll explain what are the benchmarks that he can have. And they have some restriction, limitation, or requirement for the hardware, if you can say. They have to use Z170A X Power Gaming Titanium Edition from MSI.
So you learned that well.
Oh my god, that's almost one of the first time I can say it straight. And then I blew my complete sentence by saying that, oh hey, that's the first time I can say it straight. They have to use the Seasonic PSU 760 watt from the Platinum series, Platinum Edition. Seasonic is the sponsor for the complete world tour. MSI is a premium sponsor here for this event. And yeah, that's it. They have to use some Clef memory as well. Because, of course, Clef is sponsoring this with some TDR4 Crass memory.
Yeah, pretty unknown brand to me. I saw them popping up, but I've never tested or reviewed anything of Clef. In the beginning, I didn't even know how to correctly pronounce it as well. So, interesting. So, they have to adapt again today to another memory type. And apparently, it's Hynix MFR, which is underneath. So, they already like did 30 minutes on them. All the pre-testing during the night. So, yeah, we saw already some pretty good clocking memory. Yesterday it was even better, but it all depends. You also have to have a little bit luck. We see that in CPU speeds and especially for the memory as well, it can differ a little bit. But pretty cool to see the number one of the world go up to, let's say, one of the better amateurs from last year and now go head to head. It's like if you just started tennis, to play like, I don't know, one of the big guys, like Federer or something, that's one year later.
This Orion 24 yesterday was at the workshop, so that's the 30 minutes workshop we do with the people attending the event where we are, and then 30 minutes they do compete. He finished second last year, and then 4 months after that, he was actually already doing liquid nitrogen. He tried dry ice and liquid nitrogen in less than 4 months after that. And this year is in the final for the extreme guys. So it's extremely rare to have these kind of guys ramping up that fast. He's one of the most promising French overclocker from the new generation. He's been coached by some of the best here in France as well. He's been coached by Wizardy and the Clan Osse guys. So good job, guys, because these kind of new people in the scene are more than welcome. And he's super dedicated to it.
Yeah, true. Really true. Because usually most people start off like just doing the CPU, and he went like straight buck wild, like extreming. Also, maxing out the GPUs as well under liquid nitrogen, which is like really impressive, because you have to have sometimes also the skills to mod everything. CPU overclocking is like pretty well handled now by the companies, by the manufacturers themselves, providing all the overclocking software and stuff like that. But GPU wise, you still need to do some modifications. And it's like you said, he's been coached and trained really well by Wizardy and all the French overclockers. And they have like a pretty huge community at this moment as well. That's like really fun. It has been Germany, let's say, for over the last past years, and now France is really pumping up. It's too bad that maybe for the French spectators that we don't have Wizardy anymore. We lost Wizardy during the quarterfinal. But yeah, Orion 24 is here to defend the French flag. How is it called again? It has a special name, no?
The French flag?
Doesn't it have like a special name, no?
No?
No? I'm being misinformed then.
I don't know where you're going with that, and I don't want to know, actually. I don't even want to know where you're going with this.
Okay, cool that.
For you guys, for the one versus one, we'll have all the screens. We are almost ready to go. I think we can tune in to Peter, if Peter have the headset on. Peter, can you hear us?
Yep, can you hear me?
Yes, it's okay. Everyone can hear you as well on the live. So is the benchmark already chosen?
No, we're going to choose the benchmark now. So it's the same system like before. Benchmark comes up, you can veto if you want to. If you're out of vetoes, you take whatever benchmark is
Peter,
coming.
Peter, what are the benchmarks?
All right, so the benchmarks are reference clock, W prime 32M, Cinebench R11.5, 3Mach11 physics, XTU and GPU Pi 100M. Okay, so let's do the first benchmark selection. 3DMark11 physics. No problem, and
not sure. Might be a good chance.
Clock is ticking. They have to choose.
Yep. All right. Cool. 3DMark11 physics is the benchmark. So
let's
hold on. I'll give you the heads. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
We'd have to make sure everything is ready.
Later. Thank you.
Peter, we are all ready to go. It's when you give the top for the 30-minute match.
Okay, so are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? All right, 3, 2, 1, start.
Okay, you see the bench is now cooling down, so they really have to wait till the go moment. Thank you very much, Tim. So they started now, and they chose 3DMark11 physics. So Daniel showed us yesterday already why he is number one in the world, really tweaking down the memory hard. And maybe with the lacking CPU speed, he was hoping, I think, to maybe match that one. So it's fully CPU dependent, but also the memory needs to be dialed in really well to boost the physics score. So hopefully he can, let's say, with all his experience, beat the new kid on the block.
That would be interesting. I would love to see this, because right now you have the game of the number one in the world versus one of the newcomers, someone that a year and a half ago didn't knew about overclocking that much. So that's like the top guys against the new lead.
Yeah, it's like I said, it's like a dream come true, probably. If you like really, like Orion 24 is like really enthusiastic about it. It's like it's his passion. He really got into it. And now if he can go head to head with the number one in the world, that's like, wow.
So we see the two guys in the BIOS. They are changing some of the settings. They are cooling down the CPU as well. They have to start the round being above zero for the temperature.
Indeed, and you have to get used to Skylake benching as well. So they already have like all the profiles set. That's one thing. But usually need to cool down like minus 100, 120. Go into the US, load probably a profile software wise, and then you should be running full pot. So Daniel's like doing a tactic thing. He's blowing like all the LN2 fumes in about Orion 24's space. So he looks confident. He looks a little bit more confident than this morning. It was like really, everybody was like maxing out their CPUs last night. And yeah, he already saw like, damn, I really have the least performing one in raw frequency. He even pushed like 2 volts already.
I'm sure he did that on purpose so people know, people think he cannot go higher. And then it's like, oh yeah, now I can beat everyone.
Maybe that's a mind trick. It didn't go higher, man. Because you also have to think, like, they only get like one motherboard, one CPU. If he killed it like yesterday by maxing it out, it would already be out. So he really wanted to know what can this CPU do. And he did like W Prime and even Cinebench. It was really 6060 megahertz at 2.05 volts. So that's, yeah, probably not voltage even extreme overclockers will use at home with their own gear. Usually everybody's like limiting like 1.9, 1.92-ish, but 2.0 volts, yeah. He does it. That's why he's maybe number one. He has no limits. It doesn't matter. If it scales, it scales. That's his
thing. No limits. That was one of the MSI thing. They had this no limits campaign going on. So it's actually, speaking of no limits, we are here at the Master Overclocking Arena 2016 by MSI, organized during the HWBOT World Tour 2016. And this is the competitions. We have six qualifiers, 7 events, 1 big championship, and that's called the HWBOT World Series. So this is it. We have Dan Cobb, the red team, already going into the OS and the running the benchmark. So they just have to run the physics test.
Yeah, that's true. Oh. So we see Dan Cobb is running right now. We have no signal, and Orion 24. Yeah, this could be like a small delay. He still has to enter the key. I hope nobody will copy-paste it. Maybe we should hide it from the viewers.
That's the thing. It's not going to be live anyway.
Ah, okay, cool. So he's still like upgrading to the 3D Mark 11. So otherwise, he has to run the full benchmark, which is like a waste of time. This is 30 minutes. You have to cool down. They already knew like the max frequency, so they're like pretty comfortable there. But anyway, let's talk about the quarterfinal maybe. XA had like the best performing CPU last night.
That means he will win again?
Yeah, he was like really lucky to get like the best CPU, but he couldn't max it out today. So something was off. We had no clue why. Maybe we can talk to it about him later, like during a break or so, what really happened. Especially interesting for the viewers as well, because normally XA is always in the final.
Yeah, this crazy. He's like one of the most stable overclockers, always pushing to the boundaries. We are 25 minutes in this first semi-final where you see Dan Cobb against Orion 24. And so far we have the CPU at around 5 GHz, if I'm right. 5 GHz, yes. The CPU core voltage is about 1.7 volts. This is there's still some margin for it, do you think so?
Yeah, but he's like really... Daniel's at the moment is crashing all the time, so probably his memory is dialed in too tight, and that's one of the things that especially interesting with 3D Mark 11. So it will not complete the physics test. It's not CPU dependent at the moment, so he has to find some way to get like the test running at this moment. So it's running again at this time, and will he complete it? Running. Yeah, this seems to be like a full run. So we'll just have to wait to see the scores pop up and to compare it between the two guys.
Score is 14,581.
Yeah, we have to log that one. Thank you very much.
So far, both of the overclockers have a score. Dancup is at 14,581, while Orion 24 is at 14,380. So far, the leader is the number one.
The number one, yeah. But we have seen that, let's say, in the South Africa event as well, where Vivi was like leading a long time, and then, oh, there's somebody new coming up. Oh, I have to get back. And it's like we said, the time pressure is enormous. There's also like a lot of background noise at the Gamers Assembly. Like, it seems like a discotheque.
We are in the main exhibition area, and they will have a demo show, they have cosplay, they will have, I think, the final as well. So that might be shooting a little bit even higher in the afternoon.
Okay, we got, they're cranking up, and we got 5,598, I think it was, for Dancop already. So he's running like 5,800 megahertz at this moment, and still cranking up.
So this Let's is the run, the first semi-final between Dancop and Orion 24, the number one in the world, Dancop, on the right side of the screen, actually, and Orion 24 on the left side of the screen. And there's a tight battle for them. We can see that they're almost going to see the score for Dancop. The score is 15k. Huge boost again.
Yeah, we've seen that as well during the quarterfinal. So Daniel like just did the GPU pie, and it was like constantly improving all the time. And he just kept like the system running during the entire 30 minutes. A lot of people like booting, rebooting, crashing. And he is like, yeah, he's so... I don't know how many CPUs he already did under LN2 of Skylink.
I think that's way more than that anyone can do, I think.
Yeah, so he's really into it as well. He's like benching each night 2-3 hours again. So insane, the guy as well. And also, Roman told me some background history. Like, he was like limited to water cooling for a long time, Daniel. So he always bought like the best CPUs to get higher on water cooling. And Roman said, dude, you have to step up. You have to do the extreme thing, because like, even though with the best CPU, at a certain moment, you will always be surpassed by even maybe a not so experienced overclocker just with a single stage. And that's why he went into extreme cooling. And now he has like, what, a 700 liter tuer outside of his house.
Yeah, but tanking outside just because he used way too many, much LN2. Orion is finally back in the game, benching 3D Mark 11 physics. Let's see. This bench is like 12, 13 seconds, so it's super fast.
Yeah, I think all the benchmarks here like are like limited to that. We cannot do like, let's say, 2 to 3 minute runs.
This is it. Orion just managed to pass 15K. He managed to pass the 15K, so this will be quite interesting to see if he can even go higher. Dancop was actually re-eating his CPU bot. Maybe it was about to go too cold and just angst the system.
Yeah, that's the thing as well with these Skylake CPUs. I also did my 2 days of fun on them, and one day you can run 6.3, and then like say one reboot later it's 6.1, and you have to heat up again. And the thing is, if you go full pot, almost none of these CPUs go straight for a straight boot. You always have to use the heat gun, the torch. If it crashes, to lower it to maybe 155 minus, then it boots again, then you can adjust. And we see even Orion 24 is like going for the vultures as well, so pushing hard.
Keep pushing it, guys. Keep pushing it. So far, we haven't seen any blue screen.
Disappointed?
I'm a bit disappointed for that. But it's okay. Every time you crash, or you have to reboot, or you have to re-eat, like exactly what Dancup was doing in Orion's using the torch, and every time you re-eat, you lose at least 30 seconds, because you re-eat, you have to restart the system, you have to go back in the OS.
It's true, and like many of the German overclockers use the heat gun, and they say it's like way more efficient than the torch. They can really put the heat gun in, and you really see the temperature can go, let's say, more to the positive side. Eh? But yeah, it all depends. Not everybody has these heat guns, and yesterday we had like a huge blow as well.
Yeah, that was overnight. So yeah, actually, you guys blow up the complete area for the extreme overclockers. No more power for anyone, because you just blew up one of the heat guns.
Yeah, I don't think the technicians will be happy with that. But yeah, the heat gun failed, and apparently indeed it took out everything. So there was no more power at the extreme overclocking booth. But it's cool to see Orion 24 also improving. And even though Daniel is still in the lead, he will still feel the pressure. We were talking during the restaurant last night. He said, I still have my Computex chance. So if it doesn't happen here, maybe I can do it at the Taiwan stop. But I think he's really competitive. He always wants to win, no matter how. And yeah, you should have that to do like these competitions. I would be like more, oh, if I reach like the final, it's like already cool.
So Orion 24 is improving his core, 15K and 295. So he's improving and going back into the benchmark again. Look at these, like the smokes is going everywhere. The LN2 smoke is going everywhere. This is crazy. Orion 24 back at running to the Mach Physics. Mach 11 physics test.
Yeah, we see Dankop already like in his core center doing like the 60 multiplier. So normally, like you said, if he was not like playing his tactical game last night, he's almost at the max of his CPU. This is it. This is no way that he could go like 6,100, 6,200-ish. His CPU is not able to. So he really needs to depend on all the tweaks he did to the memory.
He was at CPU core voltage of 1.98. That's quite a lot.
Yeah, it's really quite a lot. Like I said, usually you see on all the scores you see at HW, but we're at 1.9, 1.92-ish. And that's where usually most people that build in like the safe limit, it's even insanely high, but apparently the CPUs can handle it.
Yeah, we have a different meaning for safe.
Safe, yeah, true. It's assumed or it's considered as being safe.
Yeah, it's considered safe.
But you see, like this is Orion 24 screen, he's already at 6,100. So he's trying. I knew he ran the previous quarterfinal at around 6.2-ish Cinebench, so his CPU can go a little bit higher than Daniel. So we just have to see what it gives for the physics scores. Usually it's not that much, but they're only like, 300 or 500 points away from one another. It can happen. Imagine that if it would be the number one. I think nobody, if we did like bets on overclocking.
There's so many things that can happen, so you never really know.
Yeah, it's the thing with XA. He had the best CPU and today it didn't go quite as planned. So, yeah, he will be smoking a lot of cigarettes today, I think, on the outside. And Daniel is also like doing like, I don't know. What's going on? Is this the max? Let's see what happens. And this is also like always the lucky thing that you have. Like MSI binned all these CPUs and on air they did like almost the same. They were like 4,500 megahertz, ranging between 1.14 volts and 1.18. So almost no difference. But under liquid nitrogen, there's so much things that can happen. The way you cool down, which voltages that you apply, can change like a lot of things. And luckily, we had like a good test by Roman, like on the thermal paste. And that was in the beginning when Skylake was launched, that we didn't have like the right thermal paste to get like full pot. Now they're using that, and of course everybody is using the same turbo paste, so that improved the frequencies as well. So let's see if Orion 24 can pull it off and do like a 6,100 megahertz run. Would be interesting to see.
We are almost halfway through the round. It's already 14 minutes that the guys are doing the competition right now, the semi-final. I remind you guys, Dankop is the first, the best overclocker in the world at this very moment, while Orion 24 is one of the contender. And a newcomer in the scene.
Yeah, really true. He was already like way ahead of the other amateurs last year. He was like way better and already dialing in the memory. So he picked up pretty fast and all his scores at HW both have been like front page news. Yeah. So to be on the front page, you have to push really hard. And we'll see what will go on.
We had a lower score than expected on Orion side, so he's rerunning again. If we look at Dankop, same thing. He's running at 14K, so that's much lower than his actual score in the competition.
The thing he's testing at this moment is to lower the base clock. So he did runs with 100 base clock, but there's some device inside the CPU, I'm not going to techno, which could produce extra jitter if you run at a high base clock. So now he's trying to lower it to 90. We tested also some CPUs with Sozolio. At 100 base clock, he could barely do 6,100. He lowered the base clock to 90. And like after 2 or 3 minutes, we were running at 6.4. So there's a lot of things with these Skylake CPUs that you have to figure out. And like we said, not all CPUs are the same. Daniel apparently has one CPU that needs 160 base clock to go high. So yeah. fun toys to play with, but you have to have a lot of time and, of course, a devotion to pull it off. So Daniel running again with the 90 base clock. It's just probably trying to figure out some ways to boost the final score.
Do you think he choose to not veto against 3D Mark 11 physics score because you have a chance even with the a little bit slower CPU?
Yeah, look.
Oh yeah, 16K. He's
really putting on the pressure.
So it was at 15.999 just before, and now he's at 16.058.
Yeah, see, so that's the things he can pull off. Like, he knows what the platform can do, and it's really like even lowering the base clock now and maybe try to push one multi higher. That guy is so into it, and he also knows all the tweaks. No matter the benchmark, he's like, he knows it. And I have to admit, he also shares, which is like very important as well for the overclock community. If they find or figure something out, it's not like it's remaining a top secret. Maybe the
it will remain a top secret for the first competition, and then it will be put in the public.
Yeah, but I think the best benchmark that we had over the last years was PC Mark 05, where there's like a lot of software tweaks that you really needed. And still improving, 16.201, so he's pushing up. So the lowering the base clock really helped to get his performance up. Probably also running at a higher memory divider at this moment. So still 1.98 volts. Thing is, Daniel is in the lead, and he has to keep the setup alive as well.
That's the thing. There's less than 13 minutes left. So that means if he breaks the system or if he's going too cold and not working, he can lose some precious time, and maybe Orion can catch up with him.
Orion preparing for another run.
But there's 1,000 point difference between the two guys. Let's see what will be the score, the new score for Dan Cup. 16244, so it's like 43 points more than his previous score. Still going and advancing in the ranking.
Yeah, we're seeing like a similar pattern as with the GPU Pi. It's like each score, it just improves. He still manages to max it out. And of course, at a certain moment, it will be done. His CPU can't do like 6,100-ish.
Score is coming for Orion 24. Let's see once we can have it on the screen. Oh, it's going way too fast for us to catch up on this. We'll have the score update. 16K! Orion is finally catching up at 16K. This is extremely well done by this guy that over a year ago did not knew about overclocking. This is the true meaning of dedication. This is the true meaning of, yes, it's possible. You can do it even if you don't have all the tools in mind.
Never, ever give up. Never, ever throw in the towel. Just keep on pushing it. And it's the same he did. He had like the matchup against Bruno from Romania. And he's also like way up in the ranking. Bruno was also a guy which was not really known like over the last years, and we saw him last year at Computex for the first time.
That's the first time we saw him, and he did show everyone that he can do some very interesting results.
Daniel pushing it over 16,300K now, so it's still.
He's now at 2 volts for the CPU core. This is crazy. This is crazy. I think he's giving it full out. It's like, if I don't win this, I cannot continue. So I don't mind if the CPUs might degrade a little bit or anything.
Yeah, he really needs to push forward. So, and the thing is, he will probably face off one of the two guys preparing in front of us. So these are the two guys, Zozolio and Bullshooter, who had like frequencies of 6,200, 6,300 during the quarterfinal. So no matter the benchmark, they will have like a serious advantage over Daniel.
But the benchmark on Daniel just crashed. So it was almost at the end and it crashed. So it does not get any score.
Yeah.
It have to start again.
So it's running again. Let's see what pops up. So Orion already like closed down 700 points, still needs to find like 280 points or something to be like in a comfortable lead. What happens? This one is lower.
This one is lower, 16.225. It's much lower than, it's actually 120 points lower than his actual score that you have to beat. It's crazy. It's still increasing the core voltage. Like, damn, it's like 2.05 volts. Guys, don't try this at home. This is way too crazy. But for these guys, the extreme overclockers, they are competing in the Master Overclocking Arena. That's for them. You know, they have to push. They have to push to the limits. They are here for that.
Yeah, and indeed, it's like Daniel is the number one. It takes a lot of dedication and time to get there, but to stay on top, that's something else. And he's like partly vendor supported as well. They have high expectations of him as well. We have seen that with Roman and 8-Pack, let's call them the Case King crew. Huh? They had to bring home world records. They got like partly in, they were flown in by the company and stuff like that. But they also have to bring something back home that they can use for PR. And with Daniel, it's probably similar. He has to...
Number one. You have to deliver what people accept from him.
Yeah, indeed.
The benchmark just crashed. He didn't even run until the end. So the benchmark process completely killed.
You have like a calculator? Let's see what frequency is at this moment. But we have to do the 67. Maybe you can do quick math. 67 multiplied by 90.2. So yeah, so Daniel's running at 6,043 megahertz. Last night he could do 60. So yeah, almost again at the max of his CPU.
3-3-2, oh, that's 3 points close to his actual score. So maybe he's continuing to increase the base clock one step by one step. Yep. It will, because here is like one megahertz more on the base clock. This will be quite interesting to see the impact on the benchmark. And as we told you guys, this benchmark is like 12 seconds long. Just the physics test is depending only on the CPU, mainly the CPU, the memory, and this. But there's no graphics CRUD being involved in that. So let's see if he's improving his score. The next seconds. It's actually lower.
And then also the thing is, it's not because you raise the CPU frequency by a little bit that the score output would also be higher. Sometimes you have to close, you have to reboot. It all depends. And those are the things that you need to master before, let's say, coming to such an event. You have to figure out which benchmarks we will run. What are my tweaks? If I run, rerun, will it improve? Will it go down? It's the same with HWBot Prime. It's also a benchmark that you have to know how it works. Usually the first one is like pretty crappy. Second one improves, third one is better, and then it goes down again. Usually when it goes down, reboot again, everything is fine. Blue screen! That was the first one.
No, that was the recovery option.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm so waiting for the blue screen, really. Can't wait for this. So, Orion24 is struggling into his system, just going back to it. But right now on the screen, Dan Cobb is giving it hard. He's still in the lead by more than 250 points. Can he go over his actual score of 1635?
Nah.
No, it's still lower. Why would, even if you increase that, the benchmark will go lower? So you talk about the benchmark itself, but do we have some throttling issues? So the CPUs reduce its frequency or kicking some limitation? Or these guys just remove all the limitation that you can have?
Yeah, the thing is always, there's always something that we call a lucky run. But sometimes you can run a benchmark like five times in a row and at a certain moment, one score will pop out, and this is what's happening. Maybe he really needs to reboot now, get the platform running. But I think he's like, okay, I'm still in the lead. I just try to improve, run, rerun. Because if he pulls down, he probably needs to heat up again to get the system booting, losing time. And we have only like less than 6 minutes left. So probably Daniel is not taking any chances and just hopes the current score will be enough. But it's like I said, he could have like relaxed like a few minutes ago. It's like 1600, 300-ish. But then, yeah, he keeps on pushing and pushing and pushing. And he's still hoping for that, let's say, 20 or 30 points extra that could lead him going into the final.
He's talking to his computer like, come on, go, push. So fixing 300. So that is getting closer to what he have. But still, he cannot manage to go over 1635.
Yeah, I think we'll be really watching the screen on his right side as well to see what's happening there. He's focused on his setup, but he also knows that, is this our glitch or that's...
Yeah, that's our...
Or glitch, okay.
That's when they're too close to the limits. These guys are pushing to the very boundaries. It's crazy. Will this score be better at 5 minutes till the end? No,
yeah.
It's going down again.
And
so
yeah,
this is it. The countdown is there.
So Daniel's like, yeah, probably like his brain cells are like moving all around in his head, like trying to figure out how can I maybe reach 16,400-ish to maybe secure the win already. But it all depends. Orion 24 is trying to boot up the setup and see if he can really use the CPU power that he had before in the quarterfinals, if he can max that one out.
Getting back to 16k and 300 points. This is not going anywhere. Orion is struggling with his system. He had so many issues checking if there's ice on the system, more ice than what you have. Dankob is jubilating on the side. It's like, yes, I have the advance. He's struggling, so I can get on the next step.
But it only takes one run. It could be one run. And we always have the rule, if the run is started just before, let's say in the last seconds, if he pressed start and it's running, he can still complete it. And we have seen that before on some... Oh, look at
and
that.
And it's improving his score finally after that 5 minutes of trying to get the score run. He's improving his score by about 30 points.
Yeah, not massive, but it's like we said, it could be enough. It could
if
be enough.
There's only 1 point difference, we had that in South Africa with the amateur, and I'm sure we will have almost the same issue today. The challenge is that they're so close. That was 1 point difference between the two guys. So every point matters. Every little megahertz are in there, and every tweaks are important.
Let's see
the score. 16 to 17.
And that's really the thing. Like, you really need that super smooth run. That everything on the system works perfectly together, perfect harmony. And Orion 24 finally rebooting. Hopefully, you can get into the Windows and maybe teach the master what the new kid can do.
Yeah, but he does have 2 minutes and 40 seconds left only for that. While this Dankob is going full out at the real limit of the system. That's why the benchmark is 12 seconds. So it's basically calculating a workload for 12 seconds. That's it. And still, it doesn't manage to finish the 12 seconds.
Yeah, the thing he tries to match now is like we have like the CPU frequency. We also have a thing like we call the uncore frequency. So let's say boosting the memory clock and the memory controller to provide all the bandwidth of the memory towards the other subsystems in the setup. And he's like really boosting that one. And sometimes, yeah, it gives a boost. And apparently he did a small boost, but it's not giving him like 100 or 200 points. So Orion 24, all eyes are focused on him now to see what this will be. And he starts to run. Oh, this seems insanely low. Something is wrong.
Checking, opening CPU-Z to check the frequency to see if something's weird. 6.2 GHz, so he's actually almost like 150 MHz more than Dankob at the moment. But yeah. Dankob is like almost 300 points in advance, so it's...
that's sometimes really the difference. And Daniel also goes way into the BIOS. It just dials in each memory timing manually. A lot of overclockers, we have seen it here as well during the qualifier, they just loaded XMP profile and just changed the main timings, but they left alone the secondary and tertiary timings, and that's where the boost is with Skylink. If that's dialed in perfectly, you will get a big boost no matter the benchmark. So you see, it's not always the fastest CPU that is in the lead. It helps. It gives puts you in like in a comfortable mood. Like,
oh, and it's a blue screen. The first one of the competition today. We have been so waiting for this one.
He didn't like that comment.
Yeah, he's overstressed. There's 35 seconds left.
Yeah, Daniel starts to smile now. He's like, okay. Let's see what happens. Daniel still trying to push, maybe going for that final run. Why would he do that? Please tell me why he would do that.
There is 18 seconds left, 15 seconds left in this match. Let's 10, 9, 8, 7,
he
6,
started the run, so
5,
it still
4,
counts.
3, 2, 1.
Both overclockers launching their run. What's going on? Physic test. It's running. This would be an amazing run if he pulls it off now. What will it be?
What will be the score for Orion 2024 on
so
the blue screen?
So much suspense. Daniel crashed.
Daniel crashed. Oh! They both crashed at the very end. That was crazy. That's a very nice, nice job, guys. This is a very nice competition. That guy was like, yes, I made it. I can go on. I can go further in this competition. That was a very tight and very difficult battle for both of the overclocker. Would be interesting to see what they're going to have to say. We might be going to have them on the live later on today. So now the guys have about 20 minutes to remove the system, go to their table and dry up on everything that they have, and move to the next competition. So the next semi-final for the Extreme Overclocker.
Yeah, between Zozolio, I will not say he's like one of the MSI guys, but he's usually like provide like a lot of background information to the BIOS engineers and the R&D team. And so Pepino Rang is like cheering him on. Normally, like Wizardy is also like working a lot together with MSI to improve and their platform. So Pepe probably has like, dude, you have to pull this one off. You really have to do this for the love of the company. But Martin has not been that active like with Skylake. He was like one of the ferocious Sandy Bridge and Ivy Bridge benchers. And Marshall also said like he's a 3D guy. He doesn't do like a lot of 2D. And we saw that yesterday during the qualifier. We were like eating and the final ranking was not. And he said, I'm in. I'm really in. I can participate like I'm in top 8. He really didn't expect it because he really wasn't able to dial in the memory so quickly. Because he said, I usually don't touch those settings. I'm 3D guy. I really push the graphics card way hard. And if the CPU matches memory, yeah, it's not my, let's say, my main focus. And today, this is what counts. Dial in the CPU, have the high clocks, coincide, good memory timings, insane bandwidth. And that is what Daniel gave the win in this semifinal over Orion 24, running almost 200 megahertz higher. But not enough. Not enough. So if you guys have any questions of what is going on, please feel free to chime in on the chat and just pose. I have my translator here. If somebody starts talking in French, which I'm seeing, my French is pretty okay, but not for all this. What is going on?
So as you can see now, they have to dry up the system, make space for the next contestant here at the Edge Robot World Tour 2016 for the MSI MOA Master Overclocking Arena Europe 2016 final. The winner of this competition will win a flight to go to Berlin.
Daniel doesn't get a flight if he wins. He can go by car.
Oh, he can go by car as well. That will actually even be faster because they don't have that much of the speed limit anymore in Germany. So yeah, that would be extreme to see them there. The winner of this competition, as I said, the Asia Robot World Tour is hosting the Asia Robot World Series in seven different countries, five continents, and one big championship. Here, the guys are fighting for both cash prize and these flight tickets. So,
and it's like you said, everybody wants to reach the Berlin final. That's like, it's really rewarding. Like the Brazilian tour that you guys did. I don't know if the winner has ever participated in a competition outside Brazil.
BXHX, Pishiagashi, yeah. Never participated in any live competition before. So that was his first live competition to win in the Edge Robot World Tour South America. Latin America, actually. America. That was quite insane. And we had Dr. Wiz from South Africa, that is actually number one in South Africa, that did compete in the South Africa event last weekend at Rage Cape Town, and he won his ticket for Germany. So you know these like Peixe, Agashi, Paulo from Brazil and Dr. Wiz from South Africa, they already know they get qualified for the World Championship to happen in December. My dear Ligofte, we'll take a short break while the time of the guys are just packing up everything and drying up, and we will see you guys in the next few minutes.